huge amounts of research to back up that if you have mental problems, if you have, you know, if you're really suffering from well-being, if you've had trauma in your life previously, then actually by being able to go and box, you can release serotonin in your brain that enables you to control some of your emotion and to talk better about it. So I think there's so much good that can come from sport. It's, you know, it's my joy. I think it's the only place that's going to be able to go out there and champion these amazing women.
And you are very serious about this because you've got great money behind it.
Absolutely. It's all been privately funded to date, and that's a passion. It's whether my children will agree with that when they don't inherit quite as much, I'm not sure. But I do think, for me, you know, I hope now to be able to put real eyeballs on this and to have some corporate sponsorship, because the Lionesses did incredibly well, and they got the first 6 or 7 pages of most newspapers. But most of those companies still actually only fund male sport. Mm. They still actually only give the money to the Premier League when they advertise. So we love to watch women's sport. It's growing enormously. And I just think now it's my job as a promoter to challenge corporations to say, if you're going to sponsor, you need to sponsor women's sport as well. You know, we're here, we're doing really well.
What do they say to you when they say, sorry, no? Is it because they just don't think there's enough people watching it?
Yes, to start with, I think that's where it was. And I think this last year's really, really changed that into a really do. I think that now people are looking and they are seeing, and the Lionesses did that incredibly well. You know, the rugby's great. The fact we've got Formula One, you know, W1 drivers now. There's a whole build-up of it. But where I think boxing is so interesting is it's such...